Today, we have come here to do the Adi Shakti Puja. I have already told you about the Adi Shakti, how she had to work out so many things in this world. First to create, and then to create human beings through evolutionary process. After that, to comfort them. Then to counsel them. So many people came on this earth just to do the counseling. They told what was wrong, what was right, what should we do, what we should not do, what is self-respect, and what is the duty of a human being as the superior most creature. So many of them came. One after another, in every country, they came. And their counseling formed religions. Of course, you see the mess of the religions. And that's how their life was wasted. That they formed religions after religions, by which only human beings were divided. Divided to such an extent, they hate each other. If somebody is born in an ex-religion, he hates the person who follows the wild religion. Why those who came as counselors talked about complete unity, complete oneness of human race. Despite that, human brain in its freedom did all kinds of wrong things and created a country, or we can say the whole world, full of lots of problems arising out of religion. How can it be that religion makes you hate somebody? Religion is there to understand love, to imbibe love and compassion. So the third thing one had to do is the Adi Shakti's job. That is the one Kundalini within us. And by her awakening, we got pure knowledge, absolute knowledge. Pure knowledge that it cannot be challenged. Absolutity. Whatever you know after realization is absolute. If you know that, then what you have to understand, that everything has to be united. You cannot have fights and you cannot hate anyone. If that thing starts happening, all the problems of the world will be finished. So the first thing, redemption, that is the quality of the Adi Shakti, was to redeem people of their all wrong ideas about others. Firstly, as we know, there are six enemies we have got. And unless and until we can conquer those six enemies, we cannot be a religious person. That's what is said. But Actually, all religions are based only on prospering those six enemies that we have within us. When you see this clearly, you start seeking. You start seeking earnestly the truth. And the revelation of truth, absolute truth, can only come through your evolution, through your reformation, that you become a person who knows the truth. For that, Adi Shakti's ascent is important within you, which is your Kundalini. And when this thing takes place, automatically you drop all those six enemies that you have. You become a beautiful human being. Like lotus, when it is in the very germinating state, it looks like all other small animals or small, you can say, very, very small dirty things that are in the pot. And then when it starts coming out of that horrible water, it becomes such a beautiful flower, rises up and opens out. In the same way as a yogi, though lives along with all these horrible things that are going on, but flowers like a lotus. It doesn't have all these insects, all this dirt and filth of that water in which it lives. It sucks only the pure water, and the others remain there as it is. So what is left within you is nothing but purity, beauty and fragrance, just like a lotus. Then there is no more the problem of getting attacked by all these small creatures in the water, or all the dirty things that are in the water. And this state that you have achieved now, I am very happy to see so many people in America have achieved it, which is a very great blessing, because America is the leading country in so many ways. One can say that it has made lots of money. That is not the criteria for becoming a very good surgeon. What you get is the satisfaction. Satisfaction that you enjoy whatever you have and whatever others have. And the second thing that happens to you, you become absolutely collective. This has to happen. But I find still people have not understood the meaning of collectivity. For example, family is very, very weak here. Family that is being created by natural relationships is not so much respected as it should have. It's all because based on money, so people start quarreling, fighting, even killing each other. Now the basis of family is love and compassion. Those who do not have this cannot have good families. I have seen even among Sahaja Yogis sometimes, some people who are working for money, who are educated, sometimes look down upon people who are not so well off. Or maybe the housewives who are working in the house, looking after the children, building up the families, are not treated with respect as some secretary in the some organization. I don't know why this kind of a manliness comes into women. Why should they think they are something higher than the women who are working hard in the household, cooking, looking after children, wearing all the brunt of the society? This is something I feel is a part which is lacking very much in America and also Western countries. When money becomes important, if when money is important, then the Lakshmi principle is not respected. Very surprising. Money is the part, or we should say blessing of the Lakshmi. But the Graha Lakshmi, the one who is a householder, is not respected. And with this, I tell you, it's a very, very wrong things can happen. You can work, you can be educated, but you should be able to look after your family and look after their comfort and look after their unity. Instead of that, educated women, I call them manly women, educated women think that they are something higher, they are sadly mistaken. In no way a man is higher than a woman. So this kind of a disparity that exists, and one starts thinking that we are earning, we are educated, are really manly women, I must say. But the women who work very hard in the household with love, look after the children, look after the family, are in no way less than these people who are working in the office. So such women must be respected by their husbands, by the males of the family. Not only that, but all the Sahayogis must respect such women who are doing such a difficult task. I've been a housewife and I know what it is to run the house, to look after the children, to look after the complete organization and looking after the expenditure of the money if that is limited. This ego has to go. The other day one lady, she came as an interview and asked me that how is it in this world of men you are so much respected? World of men, I was really laughing. What makes them think that it's the world of men? I can't understand. Can they exist without women? But I was amazed at her question, because she said that even in the jail, criminals have so much respect for it. How is it possible? How can they have so much respect for a woman? I said, I can't understand. One thing, that criminals have got mothers or not? All males, don't they have a mother? They all have a mother. And they respect the mother. That's the point one should know, that woman is a much more important thing than the man is as far as the children are concerned. But I've seen even some ladies who think they are very capable, try to control it and create problems. A mother's job is not to control. Her job is to love, to give compassion. And this is the quality of women is lost in these Western so-called advanced countries. It's a very dangerous thing, I personally think, that if such a thing happens, families will be destroyed. Nobody will have respect for the lady who looks after the family. And she is more than a prime minister, I would say, in a family, and she is to be respected and to be understood. Today, I think it is important to say that all of you should understand the value of women who are housewives. It's a tremendous job to be a housewife. I have gone through it and I know what it is. The respect to the housewife is not given. She would also look after the children. Children are tomorrow's citizens. Who will groom them? Who will bring them up? All these manly women don't also have children sometimes. So they don't know what is the problem of children. At least those who are solving the problem of children, you must understand their responsibility. This is a very, very crucial point, I think, on which all the Western societies are collapsing, because in their culture there is no place for the mother. So the women should not feel in any way less. If they are mothers and looking after the household, they should not feel inferior to anybody who thinks that they are something great. Basically, the families have to be improved. This collectivity must work first in the family. The children are to be groomed properly. They are to be brought up in a proper way. As it is in this day, you know what is happening to the children. When I read about it, I'm really shocked that children are just treated as if they are some unwanted stuff. They are not given any attention. Ultimately, the children become drug addicts, they become vagabonds, anything, they can become anything, because there's so much neglect and so much of hatred for children. So one has to first remember that for collectivity you must look after your children. Not only that, with love and compassion. Not as somebody who is trying to become a despot out of it, but a person who is a source, of joy and compassion. In one of my lectures, I talked to you about the emotional intelligence. That is what we should try to imbibe. Emotional intelligence. That means the intelligence that is based on emotions. Unless and until we become emotionally intelligent, our society cannot improve. With an emotional intelligence, you care and you enjoy caring. You do everything for others with a great emotional understanding. Not for one child, not for one son, but for everyone you have to be emotionally intelligent. Some children are born like this, but some are to be made like that. That they should be emotionally intelligent. Because if the mother and father are money oriented, very selfish, they won't allow their child to give anything to others. So such a child will grow into a very funny type of a person and will never do anything for anybody, not even for his own country. Why should he do it? Everything for selfishness. Then such people indulge into corruption, indulge into all kinds of things which are only selfish in attitude. Now we are talking of collectivity. In collectivity, we do for others. We enjoy doing for others. We love giving things to others, not for our yourself, because your children will also become the same kind and they'll only bother about themselves. This emotional intelligence has to be brought in our life, in our pattern that we have. Are we emotionally intelligent or we are just intelligent or emotional? Both things are wrong. If you are just intelligent, you can become a very dry person. You may just have few friends, maybe you may not have, and you will always try to preserve yourself away from the collectivity. And if you are emotional, you will be attached only to one person, attached to one child, maybe attached to one person, to someone, even in the society, for no rhyme and reason. Why? Why are you attached to one person? Why are you bothered about one person only? All such people fall into such terrible prey. In the politics you have seen how people try to help their own sons and our daughters and this and that, and we Indians have suffered a lot with this kind of a emotional attachment. So, according to ethics, emotional intelligence is the highest quality by which you give to others, you care for others, for everyone, and you become very, very collected. Now, exclusiveness is another fashion that's very much there. It's exclusive. Because you don't want to be one of the multitudes, you want to be exclusive. You should be exclusive in emotional intelligence, not on other things. That is the best thing you can have. As I agree, I am just a woman and just a mother. But what I have is really the emotional intelligence, ocean of it. And from that I know about everyone. I understand about everyone. And all this work has been done because of that quality in my head. I am not attached to one person or to one style. Whatever you say, I can understand, because I am at a level where I can understand everything that you are doing. To achieve that, you try to develop emotional intelligence. Here the children won't even give a toy to somebody to play. Even the mother is like that, the father is like that, extremely selfish. And we must have our own, you see, everything should be our own. This has to go. This has to go from America, especially because they are the leading nation in this kind of selfishness. What selfishness they have done, I did not count, but you know that. You go and ask the people of Canada, Mexico, Peru, all these, they will tell you. Being selfish, they are not ashamed. Being exploiters, they are not ashamed. Nobody can even tell them because they think they are very rich people. But all these riches will not give him the joy of life. Joy of life is only in the emotional intelligence. If you don't have that, it becomes very dry, life becomes very unbearable, horrible, and even the family gets broken up if there is no emotional intelligence in the family. I have known so many women who have had 3 marriages, 5 marriages, I don't know how they can do it, but they have done. Because this lack of emotional intelligence, it is something that is a sense of giving. It is not that you are sacrificing anything, no. That's also another idea, that we have to bear these, nothing of the kind. Look at the life of Christ, he gave his life. Why? What was the need for him to do that? Behind it was the truth. When you have truth with you, the light of the truth, the force of the truth, the strength of the truth, you become emotionally intelligent. You understand that if you really love something, then you have to undergo every kind of trouble. You have to tolerate a lot of nonsense. I know it's too much to say, but I thought that for this special puja, I should say something about the family. In our ashrams, or in our programs, or wherever we are, we should remember this point, that are we having that emotional intelligence when we are trying to talk about sadhaka? Why do I need to be every place to tell them what is the need? You can tell them. If you have that emotional intelligence, everybody will listen to you. Why not? Not necessarily I should go everywhere and talk to them. In how many countries can I visit? And the reaction to it is so beautiful and so nice. It's very surprising. Like in a country like Benin country, all Muslims there, all black people, they all have become surgeons. 9,000 people. How could I capture that? Just think of that. 9,000 people suddenly become. Then also other countries I've seen, just this is the power of emotional intelligence that captures the heart of people. You may have any amount of property, money, everything. People will abhor it. So you may say, what's wrong? What's wrong is this, that you are harming the greatest thing is the human being. As the politicians, they are horrible, as they say. Why? Because they have no emotional intelligence. Also, as administrators, they are very much difficult because they have no emotional intelligence. All these people are devoid of that great quality of emotional intelligence. If your country is very progressive, I must say you must progress in emotional intelligence. That way they are philanthropists, I know. Americans are known to be philanthropists. But behind that is they want to have power. They want to rule people with that money. It's not emotional. Intelligence is they just want to rule. If they start some sort of a charity, that is just to have a big name on the television or to have a very big advertisement about, oh yes, and then he moves like a tycoon all over. We part of it they will donate, we part of their property. Work it out and make such a fuss about it. Because they want to cash it, everything. Cash has been given, so cash everything. You are such a yogi. You have to send waves of emotional intelligence. You have to send love to all over the world. You have to show how you can with love win over. It is also possible if you are not so attached. If you are attached, say, to your country only. Now, this is a bigger issue. Then you will try to exploit other countries, take advantage of them, try to run them down. But if you are emotionally attached to your country, then you will bring good name to your country by doing real good work. I don't know why people do not know how to discriminate. Why are they so selfish, trying to build them up, trying to do all the good things for themselves? There is a very great chance for all of you to get this within you. You are rich because you are all sahyogis. You have become like lotuses. And the lotus has the fragrance which spreads all over. And days together it stays in the water, in that dirty water, and it spreads the fragrance. With that fragrance also you can do lots of things, that the bees come there, they sleep in that beautiful house of a lotus, and in the night it closes down very carefully. All kinds of things that come for the flower to take the little of the beauty of that flower. We can say because you can extract also the essence of that which has fragrance, you can also get some honey out of that. Whatever is possible, everybody comes to that flower. That doesn't mean that flower in any way is weak, but that's his quality, that's his strength, that's his understanding. That's what you are. You are all made into lotuses. You are not made into some sort of creeps or some sort of stupid donkeys. No. You are the people who are to give fragrance of your love, fragrance of your compassion to others. And you should feel happy about it. That doesn't mean that you give up this, give up that, nothing of the kind. But it means that whatever you have, whatever is your possibility, capability, you must try to do for others. Give it to them. And the more you do it, this collectivity, that's what is very important, at least for America, because everybody is trying to follow America. Money-making business, this business, that business. But you are sahyogis. So what you have to do is to take advantage of your achievement and give this to others. Give realizations to others. Many people who get realization don't even bother about it. They just don't go and spread sahyoga. They are not bothered about it, which is sometimes very shocking to me, because what was the need for me to go around the whole world with all the mad people living and talking to them about sahyoga? In the same way, you should also feel now that we have to do this one. We have to change people. We have to get them into sahyoga. Why can't we? We are so many people. Christ had only 12 disciples, and how much they spread Christianity? What about you people? You are so well equipped. You have so much of knowledge, absolute knowledge and experience. So if you have the experience and the knowledge, you can capture the people. But there is some sort of a lurking ambition which goes against the culture of sahyoga. When you want to be leader, or you want to put down somebody, or you think no end of yourself, that's no good. And also they do sahyoga or spread sahyoga because they want to enhance themselves. This is not the way. The way is a complete surrender to the work of sahyoga. It's possible, it's not difficult at all, as I'm telling you. It's very, very simple. Only thing you should understand that you have a special place in the whole universe today. You are not to rot, you are not to waste your life. We have started marriages, and in America also they said, I said, all right, we'll have marriage. But these marriages, what is the outcome? If they are like all other ordinary marriages, what's the use? What are they doing for others? What sort of children they are producing? You have to see to it that you become married couples in Sahajyoga. Your family should be a different type. Your love for your family should be of a different type. The whole family of Sahajyoga also is your family. So for everyone you must have compassion. And I know some people grow very fast, but some don't, because they lack this balance between emotion and intelligence. This balance has to be completely established, and I know one day this America will lead so many people, thousands, in Sahajyoga. So far, whatever was wrong was adapted. Drug addiction, yes. Then another thing starts. All kinds of nonsensical things started in this country. Why? Now, the new lotuses that are there, they have to change the atmosphere of this lake where all kinds of dirty things are coming up, immoral things are coming up, ruining the whole world. So in our general attitude also, we should try to see, are we really following? Are we really doing what is to be done? What are we doing for morality? That's a very important point in Sahajyoga. How you dress, how you walk, how you talk, everything very important. And all other things that you have, you should try. How to create, and all these things of different chakras, you should try to concentrate on them and see for yourself what are you doing. What are you making out of your life? You are a Sahajyogis, you are special people, you are not ordinary. I want to tell you that you should have self-esteem. Try to understand what is your quality, what are you. Thank you very much. May God bless you.